again. You know, all political parties, including the DA, will have a good, the bad, and the ugly, and they'll take solace in basically seeing people gravitate towards those people. And again, KZN is another province, my home province. Shout out to KZN, folks. KZN is another province which you should watch, because KZN residents are literally beginning to turn their back aggressively from the ANC to the ANC. They're turning away from that ANC, so that you should understand and put paid any myths that there was always going to be an ANC of Jacob Zuma, which Zulus and KZN people will be swearing allegiance to. All of that is poppycock. KZN residents, perhaps scarred by what they saw in those July riots, scarred and tired of the ANC's bullcrap over the years, are literally saying to hell with the ANC and the IFP. The Inkatha Freedom Party, shout out to the IFP, literally doing an almost clean sweep of northern and central KwaZulu-Natal. It has been amazing to watch what the IFP has done in its resurgence in that particular province. South Africans are coming together, I think, and they're realizing that actually there's life beyond the ANC. And beyond that, even though their options are limited insofar as, you know, political parties, they'll still move and even are willing to support smaller political parties. And that's what we've seen as being the trend in this election. Then, which brings me to what I mentioned earlier on, but I want to flesh it out a little bit. Remember when I was talking to you about how other parts of the country are actually beginning to see change, and how the story of this election will be the number of hung municipalities. That is a municipality where there is no clear outright winner and coalitions will have to be formed.